Oh God.
We're doing it. I'm gonna give you guys a little backstory. About 2 weeks ago, I saw a picture of a girl on Twitter with pink hair, and she was absolutely beautiful and it looked amazing on her. So somehow that triggered something in me and I was like, I need pink hair. I don't know. That logic sounds very flawed, but we're gonna do it anyways. Anyways, after I saw that picture, I was convinced that I needed to dye my hair pink. So I then proceeded to text all of my family members and my friends and ask them if I should do it. And the only person who was against it was my sister, and I convinced her to not be against it. So after I decided I wanted to dye my hair pink, I was very vocal about it on Twitter and on Instagram, or my second Instagram account, Kennedy Claire Walsh 2, go follow it. And a lot of you guys were supportive. A lot of you guys were not supportive. I got a lot of messages saying, please don't do it, you're gonna ruin your hair, you're gonna look so much better with black hair. Which, you know, in the back of my mind, I'm like, yeah, you're gonna ruin your hair and you're gonna regret it. But I'm also like very confident about it. Like I really want pink hair. It's something I've always wanted to do. I've always wanted to dye my hair either baby pink or like pastel lavender. And I never had the balls to do it because I was always in high school and I was like scared of it. But I have no reason not to now. I'm 18, the perfect age where it's still acceptable to make stupid choices. I don't know. I'm very, nervous, but I'm also very excited. I don't have like any doubts. The only thing I'm scared of is my hair falling out or being like super damaged, because right now my hair is really soft and pretty much not damaged at all. I've had black hair for 5 years. I'm just like bored, you know? And when I look in the mirror, I'm like so bored of what I see. I'm just like, it's the same thing every day. I just want to change. And I know what you're thinking, why don't you just buy a wig, stupid, and avoid all that hassle? It's not as fun. I don't want to play it safe. I want to do something fun and exciting, and I'm excited to do this. And if I wasn't doing it, then I'd Jesus Christ, you scared the shit out of me. I didn't even hear you walk up the steps. So yeah, it's 7:41 a.m. right now, and the salon is an hour away, and my appointment's at 9. I'm sweating. Chances are I'm gonna be there all freaking day, and I'm literally paying Claudia to drive me and come with me and like film, because I can't do this alone. I hope I don't regret this. Let's go on this journey together. Except you are not having anything happen to your hair. I'm going through it all alone. You can live vicariously through me. So let's get this, not bread, let's get this bleach. Let's get this bleach. Oh my God. What? So my appointment got pushed back 2 hours because the girl had a family emergency. So
we're at Panera Bread.
We're getting that bread. We're gonna get some breakfast. We're just chilling here waiting for 30 more minutes. Woo! But we're here, so we're just waiting for the girl to get here, who's new to her. I look like I have no lips because I don't have chapstick on. I mean, lipstick on.
Cheers.
Cheers?
Cheers.
I can't drink it. It's too sweet.
It's bloody delicious.
It's bloody delicious. Bloody delicious.
I don't think they say delicious.
Bloody splendid.
Harry Potter?
Harry Potter?
Harry Potter. Harry Potter.
No, it's more like, do Dobby.
Harry Potter? Mr. Potter?
Mr. Potter?
Mr. Potter? Mr. Thank you. Mr. Potter.
I've been good, so I got a sucker.
I gave her the sucker.
My roots are so grown out. I think I'm dying my entire head. Pull it harder, sweetie. Yeah, rip it out of there. Like this. You do it and I'll do the sound effects. Ready, go. It's Leviosa. Wait, no. It's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
It's Leviosa. Who is that? That's like the hat.
Hufflepuff! Hufflepuff!
Gryffindor!
Slytherin!
You trying to let me slither in? I have a really good song. You want to hear it?
Yeah, what is it?
Okay.
To get my hair ruined. But
Hi guys. I know, I look super cute. It's the next day. My hair is done, but I'm not showing you yet because first I'm gonna walk you through the entire process of what happened to my hair yesterday, what we had to go through. So we went in at 11 and the first thing she did was mix up the bleach, and I believe she used 25 volume developer, which is pretty low. I think 40 is the highest, I don't know. She put that all over my head, avoiding my roots because we wanted to save those for last. So we did this first round of bleach. It took like an hour and a half for her to put the bleach all over my head because I have a lot of hair. Then she put my hair in saran wrap, which looked really funny. I look like that cartoon monkey character. I don't know. I'll put a picture of it right here. I don't even know if it's a monkey. I can't remember. She put all the saran wrap in my hair and she said she does that so that the heat is evenly distributed. I sat with that for about 45 minutes and it started to drip, like literally liquefy and drip down into my ear. So it was super hot too, like really hot. I didn't know bleach got that hot, so it was kind of alarming, but she said it was normal. So anyways, then she washed that out and I was super nervous. Throughout this whole process, the thing I was most nervous for was my hair falling out and my hair getting super damaged. But she washed it out and it was this nice orangey auburn color and my roots were really light. Or like the hair closest to my roots were really light. So yeah, it lifted to a nice color. And she actually told me that sometimes people with black box dye hair, sometimes it doesn't lift at all, like it doesn't change. So we were lucky that it lifted. Then she dried my hair and I felt it and it felt super soft still, like it was really nice. So then she started the next round of bleach, which was also 25 developer, and just went over it again. This is where things got a little rocky. My hairstylist kind of disappeared and me and Claudia were sitting there and it had been like an hour, maybe hour and a half, and she was nowhere to be found and the bleach was sitting on my hair for like so long. I started to get a little bit worried. It was also in tinfoil and I know tinfoil makes it process faster, I think. I don't know, actually. I started to get very worried and I was like, my hair's gonna fall out if somebody doesn't take this bleach off my head. But then Claudia was like, maybe she's meaning to leave it on. Maybe like it's fine because if we don't leave it on, then it's not gonna lift to like a really light color and then we're not gonna be able to do the pink. I don't really know. I don't know if she did it on purpose or if she honestly just forgot about it because it was on there for a while. So then she finally decided to wash it out. And as she's washing it out, Claudia's standing there and I'm looking at Claudia's face and she's like, and I'm like, I don't know what's happening. I'm kind of in a bad mood at this point because I feel like something's going wrong. And then she's washing it out and she's like, starts talking to me, like kind of suggesting that we can't really do pink because it's not gonna get light enough. And I'm like, okay. Like she suggested doing purple and I was like, no, I'm not doing purple. And then she suggested like maybe trying a natural type of blonde. And I was like, I did not come here to go blonde. I came here to go pink. And then this is where she really got me. She was like, so just so you know, like we can't bleach it again. Just so you know, like your ends are a little rough. And I was like, like I literally felt a tear form in my eye, but it's okay because it didn't fall. You know, I'm a big girl. I sucked it right back up there and held in my emotions like a normal human being. And so she like put a bunch of conditioning stuff on it and she let it sit on there. And then when she walked away, Claudia was like, yeah, you definitely can't bleach it again. It's starting to look a little ramen noodle-y. And I was like, so she washed it out. And then once I go back over to the chair, I see what is on my head. A big pile of yellow ramen noodles. My hair looked scraggly and like gross at the ends. I was like, oh my God, this is not happening. I surprisingly kept it together. I don't know. I like didn't burst out in tears, which is pretty good. I mean, I'm kind of proud of myself for that. She started like trying to brush it out. It was just like coming off. Like the brush, she was using a black brush and the brush literally just looked like she had brushed her freaking golden retriever. A lot of my hair came out, like a lot of it broke off. And I was like, oh my God. I was just sitting there watching my hair break off. I would like see it like falling and I'd just be like grabbing it and it would just keep going and going. And it was a little alarming. I was a little scared, but we kept going. So she brushed my hair and then she tried to dry it. It was taking forever to dry, which is another red flag because I know that if your hair like doesn't dry, it means that it's damaged. She literally had to get another girl to come over and help her dry my hair, but they finally got it dry. And once they did, honey, I have never looked uglier. My hair was literally bright yellow, which that wasn't even the alarming part. The alarming part was how it felt. It felt like hay. Like it did not feel like my hair. I could not get my fingers through it. I was like, oh my God, this is happening. This is what everyone talks about. Like when you go to a stylist and they completely fry your hair with bleach. And I was like, I'm stupid. I should have listened to everyone. Like, I was having so many doubts at this point. I was like, what did I get myself into? Why am I doing this? I'm never gonna have soft hair again. I started to like freak out, but I really kept it together. You would have never known. I was just really quiet and like kind of angry. They dried it and then she finally bleached my roots and that burned a little bit, but it was the least painful part of the entire day, honestly. So then they bleached the roots and she washed it out. And then we started talking about like color options. So she suggested like we could do a darker, like rosy washed out pink. So I was like, I need to have pink. Like I came here to get pink hair. I can't like not leave with pink hair. I've literally been tweeting about having pink hair for like the last 2 weeks. You think I'm gonna leave with blonde hair? Ew. At this point, her friend had stepped in to help her and they were both suggesting like you could do like a natural blonde situation. Like that would be really pretty because they could have gotten like a really nice blonde out of it. I was like, no, I did not come here to like get some natural looking blonde hairstyle. Like I don't want to be blonde. I want to have pink hair. They suggested that we can do like a darker pink because she knew I wanted like the light bubblegum pink kind of hair that like fades into platinum blonde. And we couldn't do that because first of all, my roots were way lighter than the ends of my hair. The ends of my hair were like this kind of like yellowy, like I don't know, this ugly yellow color. And then my roots were like actually platinum blonde, like a yellowy platinum blonde. So I was like, okay. I was at this point, I was just so scared of what I was gonna leave the hair place with because I didn't know if I was gonna end up having pink hair or blonde hair or purple hair. Like I didn't know what was going on. All I knew that was my hair was fried and it was yellow. Then we finally decided that we were gonna do a darker pink color with a kind of charcoal color shadow root, which is like roots blended into the pink. And at first I was like, I do not want to do that. Like I wanted it to be like really, really light up top and like light around my face. And I want it to be like dramatic and blah, blah, blah. But she was like, we can just do a small shadow root. The pink will be a really pretty pink color. And then you can come back in 2 months and get it lightened again once it's way healthier because there was no way they could bleach it again. Like my hair would have been completely fried if they would have bleached it again. I would have been a Brad Mondo reaction video if they would have bleached my hair a third time, which honestly, like, would that be the worst thing? Yeah, it would. No, it's not worth it. So we decided to do the shadow root with the darker pink color and I was like, well, whatever, honestly, just get this fucking yellow off of my head. Anyways, she did the shadow root and then she wasn't feeling good, so she had to leave, and then her friend took over and her friend mixed like a nice dark pink purpley color, kind of like a dusty rose color. And she mixed that together, she puts it on my head, and unfortunately I didn't get any footage of her putting it on because me and Claudia were both dead. We were tired and irritated. We had been there for like 7 hours at this point and we just wanted to leave and it was awful. But once she put the dye on, it started to look a lot better. The yellow was completely gone, so that was relieving. And I was like, honestly, it's not the pink I want, but the yellow was gone, so I don't care. So then once the dye was on, I definitely was feeling a lot better. It was looking really nice. My hair was still looking scraggly and dead, but it's fine. It's fine. So then we left that on for like 40 minutes. Then she washed it out and she was like, it looks kind of like more faded than I want it to. So she went and grabbed a pink toner and she put like this pinky toner in it to make the pink look more vibrant, which I'm so happy she did. And she let that sit for a little while and then she washed that out. She conditioned it and then blow dried it and styled it. And yeah, that is the final result. And here we are. Here's the final result. I actually kind of love it. I couldn't tell last night. I was like, I don't know if I love it or if like I'm just like happy to get out of there. But now today, like seeing it in the sunlight and like looking in the mirror while I'm doing my makeup and stuff, I freaking love it. I think it looks so cool. It's like a nice natural transition into pink. So I'm happy with that. And yeah, I think it looks really cool. I definitely don't regret it at all. So let's talk about the damage because there was some damage. When they were brushing my hair, it was literally just like coming out. Like the ends especially were just breaking off. Not bad, not like chunks, but like individual strands of hair were just like, see ya. Once she dried my hair and curled it and everything, I felt it and I was like, oh, it actually feels soft. And she was like, yeah, it feels really good. Definitely does not feel nearly as bad as I thought it would. It just got so dark in here. I don't know what's happening. So yeah, damage was definitely done. My hair does not feel as soft as it did when I went in there. And it's definitely like a little, there's some breakage. There's definitely some breakage. If you are thinking of doing this, just please keep in mind, it takes a lot of money and it also takes a lot of time. I was there for 9 hours. All in all, I do not regret it at all. I'm so happy I did this. If I didn't do it, I would have been like, but what if? Like, what if I did have pink hair? This is just like a fun change. I know I'm gonna go back to black eventually. It's like my forever color, but for the next few months, she's pink. But yeah, I think it looks really, really good. And I'm super excited. I can't wait to like do that hairstyle I do, like half a puff down with the pieces down. Who's Kennedy Walsh? I don't know who that is. Who the fuck is that? Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like this video because my hair didn't completely fall out, and comment down below and let me know what you think of my pink hair. But only say nice things, because if you say mean things, I'm really gonna get upset because I'm sensitive. So by the way, merch comes out soon. I got my merch samples. They're amazing. You guys are gonna love it. We are working on the website now. We just placed the order and it's gonna be here end of October. So follow me on Instagram if you don't already, because I'm gonna be posting updates on there and on my Twitter. I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. Bye. Yeah.